Shalom, brothers and sisters. A word from the Most High. This word is for Yasharel, for the children and the descendants of Jacob. We're in the book of Isaiah, and then we're going to go to the book of Ezekiel. Isaiah chapter 44, starting at the first verse. Yet now hear, O Jacob, my servant, and Israel, whom I have chosen. Thus saith the Lord that made thee, and formed thee from the womb, which will help thee. Fear not, O Jacob, my servant, and thou, Jeshurun, whom I have chosen. For I will pour water upon him that is thirsty, and floods upon the dry ground. I will pour my spirit upon thy seed, and my blessing upon thy offspring. We go and we look in chapter 42, starting at the 22nd verse. What happened to Israel? What did those other nations do? The nation who kept them captive. Verse 22, but this is a people robbed and spoiled. They are all of them snared in holes, and they are hid in prison houses. They are for a prey, and none delivereth, for a spoil, and none saith, restore. Now, we're going to go back and talk about that nation that took Israel, Judah. We're in Isaiah chapter 33. This is to the nations, Babylon, and what they did. Woe to thee that spoileth, and thou wast not spoiled, that dealt treacherously, and they dealt not treacherously with thee. When thou shalt cease to spoil, thou shalt be spoiled. And when thou shalt make an end to deal treacherously, they shall deal treacherously with thee. And finally, for the brothers and sisters of the house of Israel, at the end of Isaiah chapter 40, starting at the 31st verse, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And what of their enemies, the judgment? What judgments are we seeing now? What are we seeing? We're going to go to the book of Ezekiel, starting at chapter 35 and the 6th verse. Therefore, as I live, saith the Lord God, I will prepare thee unto blood. Who? Those who were evil. Those who did evil, not just to Israel. They dishonored God himself. Book of Ezekiel, chapter 35, starting at the 6th verse. Therefore, as I live, saith the Lord God, I will prepare thee unto blood, and blood shall pursue thee, since thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee. When you look in the book of Corinthians, the Most High says, come out from among them. Come out from among them. Why? Because he hath prepared them unto blood. Since they have not hated blood. What is blood? Death. Death. This thing isn't coming from a man. It's coming from the Most High. You got people that want to start a race war, but they don't understand who they're up against. They're up against the man of war. They're up against the Most High. Why? Because time is up. Time is up. We are sitting back, brothers and sisters. We're watching the weather change. We're watching the birth rate sinks so low amongst those who have held us captive that they don't have anything on record to compare it to. We're watching diseases spread. We're watching the plagues of not just the insects. We're watching the waters. You look at the waters in Florida. You look at the waters around the world. You look at the weather. In the beginning of the year, there was 16 inches of snow in the Sahara Desert. Why? Because he's going to make it bloom. The desert, whatever desert he takes us through, streams are going to flow. Time's up. Time's up. The Most High, the man of war, is here. Who's he coming for? He's coming for his people. There's no stopping this. And the race war that they want, you're fighting against God. Woe to him who fights against his maker, his creator. We're going to look at it again. The book of Ezekiel, chapter 35, starting at the 6th verse. the book of Ezekiel, what are we seeing with all these mass murders? First of all, come out from among them. If you are of the house of Israel, come out from among them. The judgment has been given. It shall not be removed, brothers and sisters. The judgment has come. Chapter 35, starting at the 6th verse. Therefore, as I live, saith the Lord God, I will prepare thee unto blood, and blood shall pursue thee. What's blood? Death. Death. Since thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee. This isn't coming from a man. This isn't coming from a person. This is from the Most High God. His word goes out, does not come back void. Why? Because God said he will not be mocked. You reap what you have sown. You create murders and hold yourself guiltless. They don't know God. Those who know God among the nations, among the strangers, among the Gentiles, would never commit acts like these. But the evil that their nations have done, the judgment of God has come. It's the judgment of God. One more time, book of Ezekiel. Book of Ezekiel. The judgment is loosed. The judgment decreed, declared, shared among the nations. It will not be removed. The Most High God, the Lord of Sabaoth, both has loosed it. Therefore, as I live, saith the Lord God, I will prepare thee unto blood, and blood shall pursue thee, since thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee. Why? Because of the evil done to the house of Israel. To the house of Israel. When you go to the book of Isaiah, God tells you what he's going to do. God tells you in the book of Isaiah what he's going to do. As a matter of fact, the prophecies are throughout. We're seeing it, brothers and sisters. We're watching it. We're watching it. Raise up a standard. Come out from among them that you share not in her sins. And those nations that grew rich off of our demise, off of our destruction, off of our repression. It's the Most High God. The judgments are loosed. You got heat waves over the Arctic. For the first time in history, God's turning it around. He's turning it around. 400 years are up. You ain't seen nothing yet. Shalom.